Now we see part 324, exercise 7.2 in trigonometry. Already we have done 7.1 previously. Now we see exercise 7.2, first and second question. Here we learn two concepts, angle of elevation and angle of depression. Angle of elevation means we view the object above the ground level. Now this is horizontal line. Here it is one object. Top of a hill, top of the tower, like that. So one girl is standing here, she wants to view the object. That means she has to raise the head and see. To view this object above the horizontal line, she has to raise the head and see. Well, now drawing this object and the eye level, this line is known as line of sight. Line of sight is joining eye level and object. Now the angle formed between horizontal line and the line of sight is known as angle of elevation. Similarly, the same concept but in opposite, the object is below the horizontal line. If she sees the object, means she has to lower her head and see the object. So above the ground level means raising the head, below the ground level means lowering the head. Here also the angle between horizontal line and the line of sight is known as angle of depression. So simply, angle of elevation means above the ground level, angle of depression means below the horizontal straight line. So using this concept, we do the problem. Here it is given, a ramp has an elevation 30 degree. Then the top of the ramp above the ground level 0.9. So throughout this exercise, above means you can treat it as h, height. That's what I circled. Above means height. We have to find length of the ramp. Ramp we know already. It is to upload heavy vehicles or heavy things into the lorry, we use ramp. That means in Tamil we say saayithalam. The saayithalam we use panni, we are uploading the heavy things into the lorry. This is a horizontal line or ground level, and it is given the top of the ramp above the ground level. This is ground level, and the top of the ramp above the ground level is known as 0.9 meter. And we want to find the length of the ramp. This is length of the ramp. This is ramp. This length of the ramp we have to find, and angle of elevation given as 30 degrees. So this is ground level, and this is height of the this top of this ramp, and 30 degree length of the ramp we have to find. Now to find this is opposite side, hypotenuse. So the trigonometric ratio connecting opposite side and hypotenuse is, we know, it is sin theta. Sin theta equals to opposite by hypotenuse. Opposite 0.9, then hypotenuse, yes. Now sin, for theta you are writing 30. Sin 30 of, so 0.9 by x, you cross multiply. So x equal to 0.9 into 2 equal to 1.9. meter is given in meter. That means x means you write length of the ramp. You are writing the length of the ramp. This will come under 2 mark only. For this no mark. For this step, for substitution 1 mark. Then for the answer 1 mark. Totally it is 2 mark. No mark for the diagram. This is the mark there. Now we come to the second one. Here it is given the height of the girl. The girl is actually standing in front of a lamppost. As she is standing in front of a lamppost, naturally the shadow of the girl falls on the ground level. So it is given height of the girl 150. Height of the girl equal to 150 centimeter. Then the shadow falling on the ground level. It is given 150 root 3 centimeter. Now drawing this, if I have to find his angle. Angle of elevation we want to find. So opposite side and adjacent side. So trigonometric ratio connecting opposite side and adjacent side is known as tan theta. Tan theta is equal to opposite by adjacent. Tan theta is equal to opposite by adjacent. So equal to 150 by 150 root 3. Here you write tan 30. Tan theta. Theta only we want to find. So cancel this and write 1 by root 3. So which implies theta equal to 30 degree. So for this 1 mark and for the answer 1 mark. So totally 10. Actually in 2 mark question, usually for substitution 1 mark, then for final answer 1 mark, totally 2 mark, no mark for the diagram. And we know tan 30 equal to 1 by root 3, tan 60 equal to root 3. So throughout this exercise, tan 30, tan 60, tan 45, this trigonometric ratio is very useful and we are using this exercise. Thank you.